Hello and welcome to my class. In this video, I am going to discuss the biology of Leptocoryza varicornis, which is commonly known as rice gandhipak. This insect is a very serious pest of rice in the eastern states of India as well as in Bangladesh. This video is the second part of the series on pests of rice. In the first part of this series, I had discussed the biology of Hieroglyphus banyan or the rice grasshopper. You can find the link to this video in the description box. In the third part, I am going to talk about Dicladispa armigera or rice hispa. Rice or Oryza sativa is one of the most important cereal crops. It serves as a staple food for roughly half of world's population. It belongs to family Poaceae, which also includes plants like wheat, maize, grass, etc. In this rice cultivation distribution map, you can see that rice is cultivated in almost all parts of the world, and India is one of the major producers of rice. Particularly the eastern part of India and southern part of India is very important for rice cultivation. That is, in these areas, rice is cultivated in a very large scale. People of these parts also depend on rice as their staple food. Now, Leptocoryza varicornis is restricted in this area. To discuss its biology, I am first going to talk about its systematic position or taxonomic status. Then I will tell you how you can identify this species and its distribution. Then I will talk about its habits, life cycle, the ways in which it can damage the crop, and the control measures that can be taken to keep its damage to a minimum level. So let's begin with systematic position or taxonomic status. Leptocoryza varicornis belongs to phylum Arthropoda, subphylum Uniremia, class Insecta, subclass Pterygota, division Exopterygota, order Hemiptera, suborder Heteroptera, family Alididae, genus Leptocoryza, species Leptocoryza varicornis. It belongs to order Hemiptera because it has piercing and sucking mouthpart as well as a very apparent triangular scutellum on its mesonotum. It belongs to suborder Heteroptera because it has a hemielytra type of wing. That is, the proximal part of the forewing is leathery and thick, and the apical part of the forewing is membranous. It belongs to family Alididae because it is elongated in body shape. Now, most authentic books of entomology include Leptocoryza varicornis under family Alididae. But there are many common and popular economic zoology as well as economic entomology books and many research papers that include the genus Leptocoryza varicornis under family Coridae. But the insects that belong to family Coridae are more oval in shape, whereas Leptocoryza varicornis, as you will see in the picture, is more elongated in shape. So it is better to include it under family Alididae. But you should note that family Alididae and family Coridae are very closely related species, and they both belong to superfamily Coridoidea. Leptocoryza varicornis is distributed in Southeast Asia, particularly in eastern states of India like Assam, West Bengal, Bihar, Odisha, etc., as well as in Bangladesh. It is often confused with a closely related species, Leptocoryza acuta, because they share many morphological similarities. But Leptocoryza acuta is more brownish in color and Leptocoryza varicornis is more greenish in color. Leptocoryza acuta also has a much wider distribution and it is found throughout India. But Leptocoryza varicornis is found mostly in the eastern states of India and in Bangladesh. Let's look at the identifying features of Leptocoryza varicornis. It is green in color, body is elongated 15 to 17 millimeters long. It has slender legs and antennae. There is a metathoracic sting gland or scent gland present in the adults, which secretes some chemicals which have very obnoxious smell. So whenever there is an attack of Leptocoryza insects in the rice field, you can smell it while passing along it. It also has piercing and sucking mouthparts, which is a hemipteran character. Its tarsi, or this part of the leg, is three-segmented, and the proximal part of the wing is thick and leathery, and the apical part is membranous. This character is the heteropteran insects character. Let's talk about the habits of Leptocoryza vericornis. Its main host is rice, but it has many alternate hosts because it can survive on other plants that belong to Poaceae family. It can attack millets, maize, bajra, jawar, and many weeds that belong to Poaceae family, like grass. Both nymphs and adults cause damage to the crops. They feed gregariously. Using their piercing and sucking mouthparts, they suck the milky juice of the tender developing grains. They are diurnal in habit and mostly active during the morning. They are found more commonly between July and November. In winter, their breeding rate is reduced, and since rice is not cultivated in winter in India, they are found in the weeds that grow near the rice cultivation area. So, in winter, the adults feed on several species of grass. On paddy, which is the main host of Leptocoryza vericornis, it has 5 broods during the cultivation season. Let's look at the life cycle. For any hemipteran insect, the life cycle includes the 3 stages. The adult stage, the females would lay the eggs would hatch into the nymph. The nymph will go through 5 molts or sometimes 4 molts, and then the last nymphal instar will emerge as the adult. If we put the scheme into the life cycle of Leptocoryza vericornis, you can see that the eggs take about 5 to 7 days to hatch into the nymph. The nymph takes 3 weeks and 5 molts to become the adult. Let's look in more detail about every stage of the life cycle. The eggs are laid in 2 to 3 rows of 24 to 30 eggs on rice leaf. They are oval and yellowish white in color, which soon becomes darker. For most insects, you would see that when the eggs are laid, they are lighter in color, and as they mature, they become darker. Especially before hatching, they are the darkest in color. In Leptocoryza vericornis, the eggs hatch in 6 to 8 days. The young nymphs have slender green body like the adult, and they have longer legs. These nymphs generally take about 20 days and 5 molts to attain full maturity. So during the larval instars, they grow the wing buds, and when it attains maturity, it has completely grown wings as well as the genitalia. All stages of developing buds cluster around the ears of the rice and suck out the juice from tender grains. The adult bud is green, about 15 to 17 millimeters long, and they have slender legs and antennae. The adults emit the unpleasant strong smell from the stink or scent glands present in the thorax. The obnoxious smell of this adult will tell you that in a rice field, there is Leptocoryza attack. Let's see how it damages the crop. Leptocoryza vericornis infests paddy crops in large numbers when it comes to flower. As they are gregarious feeders, they attack in groups and they feed in groups. Both nymphs and adults use their piercing and sucking mouthparts to suck out the milk from the newly formed grains. Here you can see the green grains. This is the most attractive host for Leptocoryza vericornis. But when Leptocoryza vericornis sucks out the juice from these grains become dry and only the husk is left around the stalks of rice. So these stalks bear the white husks of rice and the husks are empty within. The loss caused to paddy by this pest varies from 5 to 25%. Let's see how you can control this pest. As the bugs feed and breed on various types of grasses, especially during the off-season, that is when rice is not cultivated, at that time, removal of grasses from field and the field bunds or the boundaries of the fields help in reducing the pest population. So, when rice is not cultivated, Leptocoryza vericornis adults survive on the weeds that grow around the rice cultivation area. So, if we can clear out the weeds at that time, then we would kill the Leptocoryza pests as well. So, when rice is cultivated, they will not be able to come back to attack rice. Draining out the water from infested field for 3 to 4 days is also found helpful. Crop rotation is also advisable because Leptocoryza's main host is rice. If for 1 or 2 years rice is not cultivated, then Leptocoryza population goes down and it cannot attack the rice when it is cultivated again. Spraying crude oil emulsion is also found helpful. Light traps can be used to attract the bugs, which can then be collected and killed. For chemical control, 0.25% BHC can be sprayed before flowering. Since BHC is organochlorine type of pesticide, it persists in nature. So, before flowering, if this one is sprayed, then it will persist on the rice plants, and when the attack of Leptocoryza happens, they would die due to this chemical. Dusting of paddy fields by 2.5% Alrub or 5% Chlordane or 5% Malathion on paddy fields are also found useful. These two you can see are organochlorine type of pesticides and Malathion is an organophosphate type of pesticide. Let's recap the whole story. Leptocoryza vericornis belongs to order Hemiptera, suborder Heteroptera and family Alididae. Although you would see that in many books it is included under family Coridae. The adult insects are green in color. The nymphs are also green. They have slender legs and antennae. They have a metathoracic sting gland which secretes a very obnoxious smelly chemical. Both nymphs and adults damage the crop, mostly active during the morning. They spend the winter on grass. So in winter, the breeding rate reduces and the adults spend the winter on grass or other weeds of Poaceae family. The life cycle includes the egg stage, the nymphal instars, there will be 5 nymphal instars and the adult stage. It damages the crop by feeding on grains of rice. Both nymphs and adults use their piercing and sucking mouthparts to suck the juice from the grains of rice. To control this pest, both cultural and chemical control measures can be taken. Organochlorine as well as organophosphate types of pesticides can be used to control this pest. Hope you like this video. Please come back for the next video where I am going to discuss the biology of Diclardispa armigera. Thank you.